Nemo Radio is on the air.
A, B, C. A, always B, B, C, closing. Always be closing. Always be closing.
Shirley, you can't be serious.
I am serious. And don't call me Shirley.
Put that coffee down.
Coffee's for closers only.
Come after me! I'm a man! I'm 40!
Okay, welcome back to another episode of Nemo Radio. Sorry for the primal release here, but I decided now that I'm all worked up and angry and emotional, it's a great time to record my thoughts and publish them to the world. What could possibly go wrong? It's John Nemo, back for another episode of Nemo Radio. Buckle up, I am fired up. And it all ties into business. It all ties into such key core business lessons that all of us need to remember and learn and embrace if we want to see a successful business tomorrow. So first I'm going to start with what my wife so eloquently said. Well, that was awkward. Right? So we had a plumber come over to install this water filtration deal, whatever. And the guy from just the moment I opened the door, super negative, didn't want to be here, lazy, just wouldn't answer questions. Everything was, nope, can't do this, can't do this, can't do this. Nope, 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 I won't do that. I'll charge you $150 for that. And even though the owner who we had booked the call through said, oh yeah, just ask him, I'm sure he can do this and help you out with that, and made it sound like no big deal, you're giving us enough money, we'll do a couple small little things that you're asking about for free, right? So anyway, that went south immediately. And within, you know, 5 minutes of him being there, actually about 10 minutes of it, just getting more and more awkward, I finally just said to my wife, like, let's call the owner. In fact, I just told the guy, why don't you just leave? Like, this is not going to work. I feel like you're really basically don't want to be here, and you're, you know, I'm not feeling a good vibe. I'm not feeling like you care at all about what I need. You're just kind of shut me down on anything I ask. And he's like, oh, okay, packed up his truck and like tore out of here. So it was like he didn't care, but the owner just lost, you know, a lucrative job because of his employee. And it really ties into what I've been rereading lately, How to Win Friends and Influence People, written in 1936 by Dale Carnegie. I have tried very hard to base my business off this book, to really base it around the principles I learned in a book that he wrote in 1936. And one of the core things, one of the first lessons you learn in How to Win Friends and Influence People, Carnegie says, you know, about 15% of your financial success is due to your technical knowledge. So if you're a plumber, 15% of your financial success is due to your technical knowledge. Guess what the other 85% is? 85% of your financial success is due to your skill in human engineering, your ability to handle people. And he goes on to quote another great one from John D. Rockefeller, right? These were the titans of business and industry in the 20s and 30s when Carnegie wrote this. John D. Rockefeller said, you know, the ability to deal with people is as purchasable a commodity as sugar or coffee. And I will pay more for this ability, said John D. Rockefeller, than any other ability under the sun. That is how important this is. 85% of your success, you listening right now, doesn't matter if you're a janitor, an engineer, a business coach, a consultant, a small business owner, whatever it is, it's 85% about your ability to deal with people. And then the story gets better, right? So then we're like, we throw this plumber out. Well, we didn't throw him out. It was so awkward. And I live in Minnesota where we're all passive aggressive. So we have to like whisper in the corner and then go and confront the guy, you know, because it's not like the East Coast where you've been like, you know what? You're a jerk. Get out of here. Like, it was so awkward. And so then that guy leaves. So then we call, we have a VIP membership with a company, a national company that does plumbing and heating, right? So theoretically, we're like, well, we were going to use this other plumber because the owner was a friend of my wife's so-and-so and was going to give us a deal. Obviously, that wasn't going to happen. You know, nothing that he promised was going to happen. So let's go to our normal plumber where we pay a monthly fee to, quote, be a VIP member. And on their hold music, you know, you're our number one priority and all this stuff. So I get on the phone with them and we're VIP members and they're like, thank you for calling. We see you're a VIP member. Thanks for your loyalty and membership. And we're like, yeah, we want to get someone out, hopefully, you know, ASAP to, put in this water filtration system or whatever we're adding. And the lady and my wife first goes, well, can you actually just give me a quick quote over the phone, like, so we can get a ballpark if it's what we thought it would be? And she's like, nope, we don't do pricing over the phone. We have to send someone in person to look at the job. And it's like these, I've seen this with window companies where they won't give you a ballpark of what their windows are. We have to look at your house. Like, really? Windows are that difficult? But of course, the business model is we're going to get in your house. We're going to try to, you know, hobnob it and just, oh, you're here anyway. Why don't we just pay you to fix it? Like, I know the model. I totally get it. Fine, whatever. But the best part is, remember, we're VIP members of this plumbing company, and they say, well, it'll be about a week, week and a half to get someone out to look at that. And we're like, I'm sorry, what? And they're like, well, you know, we've had all this rain. Like, they acted like we've been under tsunami warnings. I mean, oh, we've had all this rain. It's rained like once in the past week, right? So we've had all this rain, and we have all these other customers with flooded basements and broken sump pumps, and made it sound like, you know, if you weren't on Noah's Ark, that basically good luck to you, right? That's how bad. The Twin Cities are under 20 feet of water. And I'm just like, are you kidding me? Like, it was 85 and sunny the last 2 days. Like, no, I know you're... So I think, knowing business, I think I know what's going on, which is I think they oversold the amount of VIP memberships because it's supposed to come with 24-hour service, right? So, hey, you're a VIP. If you need us, call, and we're going to be there within 24 hours. That's our promise. And she's like, well, normally that's the case. But because this isn't an emergency, you don't have a flood, you still have access to hot water and running water, we'll push you out a week. We have other important VIPs with emergencies, so we can't get to you for a week. And I'm like, no, that's really not going to work. I think what they did was they just oversell the VIPs and then hedge their bets with the amount of staff they have that not everyone's going to call on the same day and need 24-hour service. Get it, fine, great model, but you're going to tick people off when you don't deliver the service you promised. So I was like, no, we're paying for 24-hour service, even if it's not an emergency. Like, you promised that, like, quick response. Like, I can get another plumber out here sooner than a week and a half. I'm sure of it, right? Like, and we're not under tsunami floods. Like, give me a break. And so I lit into her a little bit, and I'm like, look, you know what? Either you can get a plumber out here in 24 hours to, since you won't give us a quote over the phone and someone has to physically be here, you can send one within 24 hours, or why don't we just cancel this membership we pay? Because I don't feel like a VIP right now. I feel like a loser. I feel like I'm at the back of your priority list. Again, this goes back to Carnegie. This goes back to Carnegie. And he talks about, don't tell people, don't worry about what you want. It has to be all about what the customer wants. This was the other thing, and this is another quote from How to Win Friends and Influence People, how we need to run our businesses. Focus on what others want, not what you want, right? What the person on the phone at the plumbing company, they just wanted to get me on the schedule at the back end and move on to their next call, right? They didn't want to deal with anything, make any exceptions. And so I raised a stink. And here's what the person needed to hear. You know, this comes from Henry Ford, as quoted by Dale Carnegie. Henry Ford said, if there's any one secret of success, if there's any one secret to success, it lies in the ability to get the other person's point of view and see things from their angle as well as your own. So what this salesperson or customer service person at the plumbing company, they were only seeing it from their angle, which is, you know what? We only have so many staff. We're booked out to next week with a bunch of jobs. I'm just going to tell this person we're busy and there's been emergencies and your thing is an optional add-on. It's not urgent. You can wait, right? So that was the customer service person's mindset. They were not at all concerned about me and my wants and needs. And this is the other big thing that I always quote on my webinars and trainings from Carnegie. He said, your customers, your clients, they do not care about you. They care about themselves, morning, noon, and after supper, right? And he said supper because it was 1936. But here's the thing that you have to remember with sales and customer service. They do not care about you. We had another example with a landscaper where we had some problems and he wrecked some stuff in our neighbor's yard. And so I gave the bill that our neighbors had to pay to their landscaping guy to fix the problems our guy did to our guy. I said, hey, you need to pay our neighbor's landscaping guy. You messed up his yard. They got it fixed. You need to pay their guy. And he's like, yeah, okay, I'll pay it. And then he never paid it. And so 2 weeks went by. Neighbors come over. Hey, you know, we just got contacted. That bill never got paid. So I call our guy. I'm like, hey, why didn't you pay this yet? You said you were going to pay it. Oh, well, and then he went into some excuses. This person's out and their parent is suffering and they're all caring for them. And so no checks can get paid until they get back. It'll get paid eventually. Don't worry. And it was all about him, right? It was about, well, I have these issues and excuses. And first of all, I'm thinking, I doubt that's really the case that you can't write a check or call this guy's company and give him your corporate credit card. Like, you just don't want to do it, right? And it wasn't at all about my concern and the fact that I spent all this money with him and gave my guy all this business. Can you get my neighbor off my back and pay him? It was just, nah, we'll get it eventually. That we have a lot going on. Sorry. And again, it's that whole mentality. And as much as I get all angry and upset, and you know, right now I'm in that phase. I'm literally in this emotional state of, I'm the customer. I'm the client. How dare you treat me that way? How dare you, sir? Right? Like, I'm a VIP. I paid for this. Why aren't you helping me? Or I paid you all this money for fixing up my yard. You know, now you're making me look bad to my neighbor. You're embarrassing me. And I feel ashamed in front of my neighbor, you know, intellectually or whatever. I mean, subconsciously, because he has to come over and be like, hey, dude, I thought you said your guy was going to pay that. What's going on? Like, so again, I, as the customer, am all upset and irate, and I'm all worried about my stuff. The vendor in this case, my landscaping guy, is like, I don't care. I got my own problems. Our check lady's out and we're behind on stuff, and I'm not going to worry about that. I'm not going to dive in and fix anything. And it's like, what the impact of that is for your business? Do you think I'll ever use that landscaper again? Do you think I'll ever recommend him to friends? Do you think these plumbing companies I'll ever recommend to anyone? No. Do you think if I get mad enough and irate enough that I can go online and bash them and fill out negative surveys and negative Google reviews and Facebook rampages? Like, we live in this era now where if you don't make things right with a customer, if you don't have great customer service, you put yourself at enormous risk, because one customer online today can do a lot of damage to your brand and to your reputation. And if you're like me, if you're a coach, a consultant, a trainer, and you are the brand, that's dangerous. If you really mistreat people and don't try to make things right and just kind of burn people, that gets out and that gets around, and you will have people get discouraged, right? And so, you know, thankfully I try to do the right things, and I always try to make it right with people if there's issues or whatever, and, you know, within reason. I mean, obviously, of course, we have to do things within reason and run a business and adhere to guidelines and things like that. But when it gets into these types of situations where you're only thinking about yourself and what you want, and a prospect or a customer is in your orbit, if you treat them that way, boy, you're really running a risk of not only losing sales, but also alienating customers and creating critics. And, you know, basically, you know, creating trolls. I mean, you're basically saying, yeah, go ahead, go online and bash me. I don't care. There's so much of this. And it's, you know, Carnegie talks about it in the book. This was 1936. You know, he talks about the dangers of not understanding that 85% of your success comes with how to deal with people. And that's why I'm rereading this book again. I mean, I have notes on it. I've read it a few times, but I go through it. I try to go through it at least once a year. At least the notes I try to go through a few times a year, because there's so much truth in here, and it really opens up your eyes to how to run a successful business, how to get that promotion. Eve has examples in the book of how to get your kids to do what you want them to do. And the principles and the tactics and the strategies in How to Win Friends and Influence People are timeless. They just work. And that's the thing that really matters. So with all that said, I have someone calling. It's probably a plumber. But anyway, I want to wrap this episode up before my head explodes. Just remember that principle. Remember that line. 85% of your success in business, no matter what vocation or trade you're in, is your ability to handle and deal with people. Only 15% is your technical expertise. That's why we buy from people we know and like and trust. We're buying you, your personality, your communication style, how you treat me. We're buying that as much as we're buying the service or product. Because really, only 15% of people are going to separate themselves based on the technical skill or knowledge. So if you haven't, or you're not in a good place with this, make sure you read a book like How to Win Friends and Influence People. Get reminded of these core principles, which is your client, your customer, your prospect only cares about themselves. And if you want to be successful, you need to get into their head. And once you really get focused on their point of view, understanding what their core desires and wants are. And by the way, a little bonus tip as we finish up this episode, the number one thing everyone wants that I was reminded of in Carnegie's book, the number one thing everyone wants, including me, by the way, is to feel appreciated, is to feel validated, to feel important. So you can guess that with that first plumber today, I did not feel appreciated or valued or important. I felt like a pain in his day. And it was, how can I charge these people the most money possible and do the least amount of work? How can I shut down every question? And then I felt very not valuable or important or appreciated on the phone call with this second plumbing company where I'm supposed to be a VIP, right? It was very much, you're bothering me. I felt unappreciated and unimportant with this landscaper and trying to get the bill paid. So many examples of that for us on the customer side. Now, what I need to do to really get value out of these negative experiences is apply that to my business. So my next customer service call, my next webinar, my next prospecting call, how can I really flip that script over and go, how do I make the other person feel appreciated and important and valuable to me? How do I engage them and ask them questions and tell me more about what you're up to and what you're trying to do and really listen well? If I can flip that script, if I can do that well today, I'm going to end up more successful tomorrow. And you are as well. So really, I know all of you have these experiences and they just get you so fried when you get treated this way as a customer. So with your next call today, with your next email, with your next interaction with someone, flip that script. Remember, 85% of this engagement is going to hinge on your ability to deal well with the other person. And the very simple way to deal well with people, if you can remember nothing else, is appreciate them, validate them, make them feel important, put them as the star of the show, see what you can do to help them solve their problems. And then it becomes very easy to have a good resolution, have a good sale, et cetera, et cetera. So to finish up my plumbing stories, I did get interrupted with calls. Funny thing, once I told the plumbing company where we're the VIPs that I wanted to cancel my membership, I got put on hold for about 5 minutes and then was told a plumber will be there within an hour. So apparently the floodwaters have receded. Apparently Noah's Ark has not yet sailed. Apparently there was an opening. The guy's like, I'll be there in 10 minutes. I'm like, are you kidding me? See, it's so crazy. I had to go to that extreme, threatening to cancel everything to get service. And again, I'm not happy. I'm not validated. I'm not feeling important. I'm feeling like, man, I had to jump and hop and scream to get the service that I thought I paid for and get treated well. So let this be a lesson to myself, to you, to everyone listening, to plumbers worldwide, and anyone who has to deal with humans. So important. Thank you for listening to my rant. Thank you for, enjoying Nemo Radio. I will be back with another episode soon. Hopefully not as psycho and as upset, but you never know. Thanks for listening. We'll see you soon on another episode.